Hello, welcome to Mowgli TV. Today we're going to talk about a concept that is quite important in VJing when you're compositing and putting together the file that you're going to use to perform with, which is layering. And if you stay till the end, I'll be giving out a discount code for BPM Audio Shapes 7.22, which is an extremely versatile plugin for Resolume that will cover a lot of bases for any work in VJing. So, layering. There's many takes on how you should do this. There are no strict rules. Whatever I'm going to tell you is just a few guidelines that you can follow or not. As I always say, the rules are there are no rules, but it's good to know the rules to know when and how to break them. There are many reasons why you want to layer your content, either to create new things out of different things that you've got by be adding masks or adding details, or having a foreground object on top of a background and creating things that you didn't have before on the fly. See how they operate in real time and apply effects and whatever else to them. So basically layering is compositing to a certain extent, but the layering that I want to focus on today is the layering by which you are thinking of using it in a live setting. Using layers in a thoughtful manner will enable you to be very reactive when you're performing live, as in you'll have a composition that you can break down and build up according to what the music's doing very, very simply, just by switching the layers on and off without changing the overall style of what is happening, making you extremely reactive without necessarily having to know the music beforehand. In the following examples, I'm going to use three layers. There's a number of reasons for this. As I've said before, you can do whatever you want. You can use as many layers as you want. And I'm going to focus here on purely the visual aspect of what your show file is. Many people will need to have extra layers with sponsor logos, DJ names and whatnot. So talking purely about the visual content that you're going to be using to be manipulated live and doing what a VJ does. So three layers are the basis of having a background, a middle ground, and a foreground layer. You can think about this in terms of distance, or you can think about this in a more abstract way in terms of how your composition is working. It doesn't need to correspond with depth necessarily, although it's very useful to also create that sensation of depth. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using BPM Audio Shapes 7.22, which is available on Gumroad, link in the description, and I've picked this source to use as the basis for this tutorial because it very much shows you what you can do when you use a single source or a very similar single source and layer it to create something a lot more complex that you can manipulate live in a way that allows you to be very reactive to whatever's happening with the music. So what you see right now is the default for BPM Audio Shapes. This is what it looks like when you first load it into Resolume. Just going to switch that layer off, and from that default one I've created this basically, which is going to be our base layer. So that will be on layer one. This is sound reactive. I'm going to trigger the audio here so that you can see that. So that's our basic layer. From there, I've literally just duplicated that clip onto this next one, tweaked some of the parameters of BPM Audio Shapes to make it slightly different, and basically this is what that second layer is doing. So as you can see, we're building up on the same theme that we've got. It's the same shape, it's similar color scheme, it's just that the motion's slightly different and it's got a slight lighting effect, which basically gives the whole thing a lot more vibrancy and helps you when building up and breaking down along with the music. Lastly, for a foreground layer, again, I've duplicated the clip. I've manipulated some of the settings here on BPM Audio Shapes. That's our third layer. So as you can see, we've now created out of three layers with very similar content an animation that is a lot more vibrant and it's got a lot more potential to be easily manipulated live simply by switching the layers on and off. So that is one way to creatively use your layers so that you can use them to perform and bring the energy up and down accordingly. This brings up a lot of possibilities. What I've done here on column three is actually just literally replicate exactly what I had in the previous column, but let's just trigger it. And as you can see, it looks similar, very different. The energy is toned right down. That's achieved simply by changing the blend modes. If we go to the first column, you see that I've got alpha 50 multiply and alpha. Well, on this column, it's 50 mask, 50 burn, and alpha. So that's another good thing to bear in mind when you're composing your performance file. If we have a look at this column and see what happens when you switch the layers off, it's a very different effect to the previous one, because effectively the first layer here is a 50 mask, so it's actually toning things down. So if we switch that one off, it brightens everything up. So I mean, this is something that you need to bear in mind when you start composing things in this way. But basically, now we've got these two columns, you've got a lot of options, because obviously this is more toned down and this is a bit more aggressive and a bit brighter and a bit more in your face. Now you've got the two columns that you can switch in between, and within those columns you can switch different layers on and off to build up and bring down the energy. So you can use this technique to compose a document file in which you might have three columns, let's say, that have very similar content, just like I've just shown you. And then you can use these three columns to switch between different sections or different phrases of the music. And then you can actually get into the individual layers of each one of these columns to build up and bring down the energy as the phrases progress through the music, which gives you a lot of different tools to be playing with while you're listening to the music. Let's look at another example using the concept of background, middle ground, and foreground. So again, this is BPM Audio Shapes, and this is the background layer, which as you can see is quite subtle, because that's what is best usually if you're trying to get the depth element in this concept of the three layers. So usually things that are brighter will appear as they're closer, things that are darker will be pushed further back. All this is very much up to your discretion to decide how much brightness you need to get the depth that you're looking for when you're composing your animation. So this is quite a simple thing, which might be a bit boring and subtle to use on its own. Then again, you could use sound reaction to spice it up, but you've got to think of it as something that's being used in the context of the three layers. So then we've got our mid-ground layer, which is this hexagonal animation. And now you can see how the two layers are interacting. The beauty of using generative content, like in the case of BPM Audio Shapes, is that all the cycles within the animation are always tied to your BPM clock, which means that the interactions between them are always synchronized, creating animations that don't exist on the individual layers. The interplay between them is what creates the dynamic feel of the whole motion. Let's click on the top layer, which is our foreground, and now we've got this triangle, which again is interacting nicely with the motion that we've already got in place. If we now trigger the audio, you can see that we've got something that is very much in sync with the music, that is going with the flow of it, following its energy. And again, we've got a lot of possibilities here, just playing with the different layers. So once you've got something like that composed, something very simple to do, again, if you're using generative content, you could do similar things using video clips by using clever use of effects on all the different clips. You've got to alter things slightly, whether it's the color of them or the blur glow they might have, or whatever you like. So if we literally just duplicate, and now we just go through all the different clips we've got here. So this is the one there, and this is the one here. So thanks to the live versatility of generative content, I can instantly change this animation into something similar but different. For example, I just changed the shape here. So we got a triangle, and next we can maybe have the asterisk. So now we can easily change from that to that at the touch of a clip. And also, we've got these two columns, which are similar, but different. We can change this further if we want by changing the other two layers. So maybe we want to change the hexagon here into a triangle, and then change the base layer from the circle to a hexagon. So now we've got these two columns, which are very similar but different. So you can interplay with them and use them as part of your VJing strategy as the music progresses to different phrases. So that's it for this tutorial. The takeaways here are to remember to use your layer structuring as part of your performance plan. Sometimes you need to layer things just to create something specific, so that won't work. But if you're creating a show file, it really does pay off to think about these things before before getting in there, especially if you're VJing to music that you've never heard before. You have to be prepared to react to whatever the changes are. And sometimes this is very predictable, but sometimes it's not. So it's good to have a few tools at your fingertips that you can rely on whenever the unexpected happens. Another good tip to remember is to use generative content, whether you create it yourself within Resolume using the provided sources, or whether you're using a plugin like BPM Audio Shapes. Generative content is extremely handy for a lot of reasons. I've done other videos just on this subject, but think about how easy it was for me to create a three-layer basic thing and evolve it from there into something that progresses through time, so that you can have a thread that runs through all your visuals while constantly changing them. This is extremely powerful, and it's a really, really good time saver. So if you'd like to start exploiting the possibilities of BPM Audio Shapes, here's a 25% discount code for you. If you go to the link in the description and in the checkout use code BPM YouTube, you'll get 25% off. That will be for the first 10 viewers that use the code. I hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial. So as always, please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you here next time.